Well, C4 is here to lead us into the Labor Day weekend. Where does time go? Summer's over already. The Orioles season's been over for months.
I'm excited. Don't go there. I'm excited. Adley Rutschman is coming, so I'm excited.
When do you think he's going to get here?
I think he's going to get here in late September. I think it might bring
him up. You
think
they're going to call
him
up this year?
Just a couple of games at the end of the year. Give us a taste for next year.
I'd love to see it. I have my doubts that they'll rush him up there, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Meantime, tomorrow is the last day of August. We are already guaranteed that August will be the fourth month in a row with an average of a murder a day in Baltimore. And I did the math today, and it looks like we will at least tie the highest murder number from the last 5 years, if not beat it. The beat goes on.
It's more than the beat goes on, Bill. We actually have over 500 non-fatal shootings to go along with the tragic number of homicides. Carjackings are up 20-some percent. Our aggravated assaults are up 2%. Now, there are other levels of crime, robbery and different things that are down. But what's so frustrating, I think, at this point is we have our Fraternal Order of Police president and the union at odds publicly with the mayor, with the commissioner, over how to address these issues. And at some point, adults in the room need to say, whatever our individual problems are, let's deal with this violence that's going on.
You're one step ahead of me. I was just going to bring that up because it seems that the most energy now is being expended fighting with each other about whether we should go in any one particular direction. Now we've got the city council president trying to play the role of peacemaker
Between
his police department and his police union.
The Henry Kissinger of our time, trying to pull people together. Look, Bill, here's the deal, and this is where I think a lot of people are. There's been talk about the state coming in, whatever role of a management or receivership or takeover. What we're watching play out publicly right now only fuels that discussion of having some oversight beyond just giving money. Because the mayor met with the police commissioner, with the governor last Friday, and had a resource list of what they wanted. But people are going to say, why should we be giving money into this without some controls in place? Like, children, stop. Like, that type of, children, cut it out, work together, play together.
And in the meantime, we had a week that involved that incredible piece of audio the other day that made Baltimore sound like the Wild West with gunshots.
But that followed the night before, which still I think we have the appropriate questions to, that followed this same individual trying to run over a police officer, trying to shoot at a police officer, and yet the chase was called off for whatever reason. The questions a lot of people have is, what danger was that placing us in to have this individual on the streets without, and they had him, they could have chased him, but they chose not to. They called the chase off.
They're always worried that something's going to happen during a chase like that.
If he's shooting at a police officer, that to me is different than somebody that just robbed a place. If you just shot and tried to run over a police officer, what does that mean the rest of us are in store for at that point?
It just sounds like one of those questions where there's no good answer.
Yeah, well, not to me. The good answer was catch him. The good answer was not to allow him to get 24 hours to potentially harm other people.
And I want to change topics real quick. You talked to Calvin Ball, the Howard County executive today. And he talked about the new redistricting plan that's been proposed. Move 7,000 students of all ages to new schools. What was your take on that when you heard it from him?
My take on that is, and people need to understand, that Dr. Calvin Ball, the county executive of Howard County, he gives money to the Howard County school system. But in essence, these jurisdictions, whether it's Howard County, Baltimore County, they all run independently. The school system under Dr. Martirano, as well as the school board, they run without the county executive telling what to do. What I got from this from him was equity, equalness, fairness, socioeconomic. I think pretty much he might be opposed to it, but there's not much he can do. What we need right now, Bill, is to understand why is moving these 7,300 children all over the place and displacing other children, how is it going to benefit academically these kids? How is it going to benefit them when it comes to after-school activities? There's no real explanation of the benefit in this. I haven't heard it at all.
Question coming from many parents is it more about balancing school populations
exactly.
or is it more about social engineering?
And this is in a county, I want to remind people, this is in a county that is the most diverse county almost in the United States of America. I call it the United Nations of Maryland. When you look at all of the different groups, as you mentioned, there are translators sometimes in PTA meetings because of the parents that come to the school. There's something sinister, I'm just using that word, in this process that is doing this for no discernible really visible reason.
Full disclosure, I'm the parent of a former Howard County High School student, and you could not have gotten much more diverse at his high school, and it worked magnificently.
So why are we doing this? It's a rhetorical question, but why are we doing this?
Good question from C4, heard middays here on
WBAL. Great to talk with you, Mr. Bill.
It's nice to have you
back.
Been
a minute.
And you're going to be away for a couple of days.
I'm going to get away. I'm not telling you where.
Good luck.
Thank you.
C4 heard middays here on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.